Bakit maraming grasshoppers at saka mga dragonflies? Nasaan na yung mga butterflies? Gusto ko makakita ng mga monarch butterflies.
Alam mo ba, noong 1999, umusbong ang monarch butterfly controversy?
Gusto mo bang malaman?
Oo!
Sige, halika, alamin natin.
Sige, alamin ito. Natin.
Let us define what is a bitticorn. Bitticorn contains a gene from the bacterium Bacillus thuringiensis that allows a corn plant to resist insect pests known as the European corn borer. To transform a plant into a GMO plant, the gene that produces a genetic trait of interest is identified and separated from the rest of the genetic material from a donor organism. Most organisms have thousands of genes. A single gene represents only a tiny fraction of the total genetic makeup of an organism.
A donor organism may be a bacterium, fungus, or even another plant. In the case of bitticorn, the donor organism is a naturally occurring soil bacterium Bacillus thuringiensis.
And the gene of interest produces a protein that kills Lepidoptera larvae, the European corn borer.
Benefits of bitticorn to the farmers. Improves corn yield and profitability. Improves crop management effectiveness. And improves opportunity to grow field corn in the event of severe pest infestation. It also solves the problem of farmers when pests burrow inside corn stalks where they are difficult to see and inaccessible to most pesticides.
Year 1995, the Environmental Protection Program of United States approved the genetically modified corn.
There have 10 varieties of BT corn registered and approved. The registration is only valid for 5 years and need renewal after it.
EPA ensured that BT corn does not pose an unreasonable risk to man or the environment. Taking into account the economic, social, and environmental costs and benefits of the pesticide. They also guaranteed a safe level of food pesticide residues in foods.
EPA did not specifically require tests for possible effects of BT on monarch butterfly larvae. But since it was well known that BT was toxic, Janet Anderson notes that the agency assumed that BT corn could harm monarchs if they were exposed to it.
That means that monarchs were unlikely to be present in the cornfields.
Monarch butterfly or the Danaus plexippus lay eggs on one type of plant, the milkweed. When the eggs hatch, the caterpillar feeds exclusively on the weed. Monarchs lay more eggs in milkweeds than in cultivated fields.
In 1999, Dr. John Lucy, together with his co-researchers Dr. Maureen Carter and Dr. Linda Rayer of Cornell University in New York City, studied to find out whether the weeds in BT corn fields could serve as an alternate host for the European corn borer. They noticed a large amount of milkweeds around the cornfields.
We'll be right back. belittling the Cornell study, appeared widely in the U.S. and on British television. Agricultural companies launched web pages downplaying and, in some instances, ridiculing the study. The president of a major biotech company stated, "If the scientists chosen a different insect, it is likely that few people would have responded to the paper." They used the monarch, however, loved by the school children, gardeners, and millions of other people throughout the world. The world press latched onto the study even before the article was in print, and soon, protesters wearing corn and butterfly costumes were marching in the streets.